Introduction to the Delta-wye Transformer Connection, Part 7. In this section, we're going to take a look at how these transformer phase shifts are actually defined. Throughout this series, I've been using this definition for this transformer connection. This is a formal way of defining it, and this is an informal way of defining it. So we'll take a look at how to interpret these two things. To really understand the phase shift for the Delta-Y transformer connection, we have to understand the quantities that we're actually defining. We'll take a few moments to go over this very quickly. VAG is the voltage that is measured across line A and ground. VBG is the voltage that measured across line B and ground. And VCG is the voltage measured across line C and ground. And you see that's the high voltage side or the delta side of our transformer. Similarly, we have voltages that are measured across each individual winding. We have the high voltage winding and then we have the low voltage winding right here. So for winding A on the high voltage side, V phase A measures the voltage across the polarity side of winding A and the non-polarity side of winding A. Similarly, V phase B voltage measures the voltage across the polarity side of winding B and the non-polarity side of winding B. And then same thing over here for V phase C. Similarly, we're measuring the voltage across the polarity side of the low voltage winding A and the non-polarity side of the low voltage winding A. Same thing with winding B and then winding C. Okay, now line-to-line voltages are a little bit tricky. So on the delta side or the high voltage side, the line-to-line voltage across line A and B, we've labeled that as VAB, which is also equal to the voltage across winding A or V phase A. Okay, you all see that? Now, if you're having a hard time understanding this, just click on this link here where we talked about it in the previous tutorials. Okay, so the line-to-line voltage across line B and line C, we've labeled that as VBC, which is also equal to the voltage across winding B on the high voltage side. And lastly, the voltage across line C and line A, we've labeled that as VCA, and that is equal to the voltage across winding C. Now, the line-to-line voltages on the low voltage side, it's a little bit more trickier. Because our transformer is connected in Y, as you can see here, Y grounded, the line-to-line voltage across line A and B is equal to V phase A times the square root of 3, and then shifted by 30 degrees. Now, if you're having a hard time understanding that, just click on this link here where we talked about it in the previous tutorials. Similarly, the line-to-line voltage across line B and line C, we've labeled that as VBC, and the line-to-line voltage across line C and line A, we've labeled that as VCA. Okay, so now that we've talked about all of these quantities, let's introduce one more quantity. You see that our low voltage side is connected in Y, correct? So this low voltage side is also grounded. So all of the non-polarity side are all connected together like that, and they are all grounded, which means that we could also label this voltage, which is measured across winding A, as VAG, because the voltage measurement is across the polarity side of winding A and to ground, right? So VAG. Similarly, we could take the voltage across winding B on the low voltage side, and we could call this VBG, and then lastly, do the same thing here, VCG. Okay, so there's one more thing that we really need to note about the voltage across the primary winding and the voltage across the secondary windings.